Welcome back to my channel, folks. I am Prince Joseph again from Open Source Enthusiast. Today I will show you how to create your first AWS EC2 instance for free. AWS EC2 stands for Amazon Web Services Elastic Compute Cloud, where you can create machines to host your web applications. So let's get back into our topic. I want you to know what's the prerequisites to continue on this tutorial. You need a verified AWS account. You can create an AWS account from the official AWS website. You need to enter your personal and debit or credit card details to create a free account. Amazon will not charge for the services included in the free tier for the first 12 months. Check the description box to find free tier limits and to create a free account. So let's put your hands into it without wasting any time. I'm already logged into my account. You can select the region where you want to create your instance. Then from services, select EC2. This is AWS EC2 console. Here running instance is 0. Click on running instances. From there, click on Launch Instance. Now you have to select an AMI, Amazon Machine Image, to create your instance. Here I search for CentOS 7 image. It is available in AWS Marketplace. I select free tier eligible CentOS 7 image. Click continue. Now you have to select the instance type. It is T2 Micro by default, which is free tier eligible. You can select T2 Nano. If you need larger systems, you can choose T2 Small, T2 Medium, T2 Large, T2 X Large, and so on. But please note that larger systems are not available for free. You have to pay for it. If you are a beginner in AWS, T2 Micro is enough for educational purposes. Click on Next, Configure Instance Details. In Configure Instance Details section, we can set number of instances, network, subnet, public IP options, etc. I go with all the default settings. It will be fine for our first instance. While we creating production servers, we have to change default settings to custom settings as our infrastructure needs. We can change network to custom VPC and can set any particular availability zone in subnet. Now click on Next, Add Storage. Add Storage. Here by default it is allowed 8 GB SSD. I continue with that. If you want to increase the size, you can have up to 30 GB on free tier. Now click on Next. Add a tag. Here add a name tag. My first instance. Now click on Next. Create a new security group. Security groups are used to open the instance ports. If we don't configure security groups, we can connect from our local machines. We can limit exposure of our ports using security groups. Here SSH is already open to all. Any client can connect to this port. Now I am not going to limit ports on this instance. I leave SSH as open to all. Now I am going to open HTTP and HTTPS ports. Now port 80 and port 443 are also made available for all networks. Now review and launch. Improve your instant security. Yeah, this is showing because we are allowing all IPs from the outside. If you want to secure your instance, you can allow only preferred networks. You have to create a key pair for the first time to connect to your instance. Add a name for the key in the box and download the key. It is downloaded. Now click on launch from the bottom. Now the launch will start. It is first subscribing to the AMI I just selected. The instance is launching now. Click on the instance ID to get back into the console. The instance state is running, status check is going on, that is initializing. Let's wait for complete the status checks. So now the status checks are completed. Now the instance is up and we can connect to the instance. Just click on connect. Here AWS will provide an example connect command. Here the example command is for connecting to the root, but we can't connect to root directly. I will show you how to connect to the instance. Just copy that. Then go to your terminal. The key is in my present working directory. The key file permission is 644 now. This is an issue. I will show you. This key will not allow us to connect to our instance. Warning: unprotected private key file. The permission is too open, so we have to protect the key file. Limit its permission to 400. Now we can connect, but the root access is not there. We get a warning as login as CentOS rather than root. We have to change the user to CentOS. Now we connected to the instance. Just type sudo minus I to get the root access. Now we get into the root account. Now I'm going to update the instance packages. The update is started. It will take some time. Update is completed. Now install Apache by typing the command minstall httpd. Apache is installed. Check if Apache port is up by using netstat command. Port 80 is not up yet. Check Apache service status using the command systemctl status httpd. Here we can see that Apache is inactive. Start Apache by using command systemctl start httpd. Now Apache flash is started, but it is disabled. Enable Apache service by systemctl enable httpd. Now go to Amazon console again and copy the public DNS name of our instance. Paste it in the address bar of the browser. We will get the Apache test page. We can try this by using the IP also. Now our Apache web server is up and running. Thanks for watching the video. If you find this video useful, please like and share the video. By doing this, you are helping the YouTube algorithm to spread this video to more people. Also, subscribe my channel to get more Linux related videos.